In today's video, we are seeing if it's possible to carve eggshells using the acid found in vinegar. Guys, in a previous video, you saw me dissolve an eggshell to make a rubber egg using the acetic acid found in vinegar. So today I want to put that to the test. You've probably seen those really cool eggs that people carve and make really, really pretty designs. Well, they're beautiful, but they take a lot of time. I want to see if we can make a cheap method today. Here's the basic idea. We have three different substances that should make eggshells impervious to the acid found in vinegar. Let's see if we can carve patterns on these shells using these substances. Now here's where this idea came from. I'm not sure if you've ever seen that really easy kid science project where you use basically a darkly colored soda and fluoride toothpaste. Now what you do is you coat one side of an egg with fluoride toothpaste and you drop it into a cup full of soda. What happens is the eggshell itself will actually start to become a mottled brown or a dark sort of color where the toothpaste isn't. The basic idea there is that it's showing you just how fluoride protects the enamel on your teeth and what soda can do to your teeth as well. So I want to go ahead and see if using toothpaste we can basically put a design onto an eggshell, dropped into some vinegar, and see if it will actually protect it from the acetic acid found in it. There's two other things I want to try as well, both a clear nail polish and a clear acrylic varnish. Now the reason why is because I want to see if just putting a coating on the outside of the shell is going to protect it from the vinegar. I'm not sure if it will, but I want to find out. Alright, so we've got our supplies, we've got our eggs, let's go ahead and get started. So for our first test, I'm going to go ahead and try our fluoride toothpaste. Now, I don't really think even using a squeezy tube, that's going to come out very pretty. So we're going to go ahead and use a dosing syringe to get that toothpaste into a design on our eggshell. That should work. All right, let's see if we can make this happen. Now, normally when you carve an egg, you want it to go all the way around. I'm not going to worry about that today because I want to be able to set this down to see if it can dry just a little. So we'll just do one side of each. So anywhere that our toothpaste or our paint or our nail polish is going to be, that's where, hopefully, the eggshell will not dissolve. All right, next up, clear nail polish, quick drying. So for our nail polish and our acrylic varnish or polyurethane varnish, I'm gonna go ahead and make our designs a little more intricate because I'm crossing my fingers that these might work just a little bit better simply because I'm not sure our toothpaste is gonna dry. So we're gonna go ahead and leave this one for now, start on our acrylic, and once this is dry, we'll go ahead and do the other side. One side on the acrylic egg done. So now that our nail polish egg is dry, I'm gonna go ahead and flip it over, work on that while this one dries. So it is much harder to see the acrylic paint on this egg, but that's the point. By the time everything dries, and if this works, I want it to look like just a regular egg. So I'm liking the fact that it's so hard to see. All right, so while those dry, I actually have one other idea for our eggs. Now right here, I've got an egg that I hollowed out earlier. You can see that I've put little pinholes through it and then blown out all of the guts. And the reason why is because my hope is that without the inside, it may actually allow the vinegar to seep into it too. Might make it a little bit easier for the eggshell to dissolve wherever I don't have anything covering it. Let's see what we can do. While that dries again, next coat to the next one. I have the nicest handwriting, guys. Plain egg, and just within a couple of seconds, you can start to see the carbon dioxide bubbles forming on the surface of that shell. Our toothpaste egg, which is just a messy nightmare, let's be honest here. Nail polish, our regular acrylic paint, and our hollow egg, which is only just occurring to me that I think it's gonna float. So most of this egg is already covered in acrylic paint, so I'm just gonna make sure that the part with TKOR is face down. Fingers crossed that works. Oh yeah, that's just gonna sit like that. Now this is a good sign already. You can see on the nail polish egg and the acrylic paint egg that is solid, not hollow, you can see that where I've got the acrylic paint and the nail polish, the bubbles are forming around those places. That's a good sign. We don't necessarily need to cover these up, but it smells a lot like vinegar in here. So I'm gonna go ahead and cover the tops with saran wrap. We'll leave them for 24 hours, see what happens. All right guys, so I'm gonna be honest with you. I left these eggs over the weekend and most of them died. By died, I mean that they completely dissolved. Some of them were just total messes and there wasn't anything left. So we started a new batch. These ones have been in here about 24 hours. There were two that I left because I thought they were pretty interesting. The toothpaste egg and our hollow acrylic egg did things I wasn't expecting. So let's go ahead and take a look at all of these and just kind of show you how these turned out. You've seen us make a rubber egg before by dissolving off the shell using acetic acid found in vinegar before. So this is just one of those eggs and how it's done. The shell itself is slime, basically. And what you're left with is just a rubber bouncy egg that you wouldn't want to bounce because it's rotten. That'd be disgusting. We have one very, very squishy egg with almost all of its shell dissolved. You can see where it kind of raised up to the surface. This part wasn't fully submerged in the vinegar, but even that would come off if I just rubbed it enough. All right, so our toothpaste egg. I think there's still an egg in there. This actually just ate all the way through. Now, it had started to crack in spiderweb, and now the shell is, it's still there much more than the other eggshell, but it's still goopy and it could still come off. So is toothpaste going to save an eggshell from acetic acid? No, it's not. You can just see the difference. So we're gonna go ahead and wait on our two painted eggs. I think these two actually probably had some good results. So fingers crossed, I wanna take a look at our hollow egg real quick because this one also looked like it was going to work, like the toothpaste one. Now the toothpaste one was fascinating because it held out longer than the normal plain egg did. With our hollow egg, it survived, but in a fascinating way. I don't even think I can take this out of the vinegar because all that's left right now is the bubble skin. There's nothing it's protecting on the inside. So while there are some places that you can see that the acrylic paint sort of saved the shell, I think it actually got inside, ate up and around in it. And so now it's just, it's that. Yeah, there's vinegar. And this is what makes me think that the shell fully got eaten through is because you can actually see that there's liquid inside. This was a fully hollow egg. It just soaked up the vinegar. The vinegar somehow managed to get in the egg through those little tiny pinholes. I don't even know where, but the shell itself is just flaking into pieces in my hand now. So that's really gross. So first we'll go ahead and take a look at our egg that was painted with nail polish. Now already I'm kind of excited because you can actually see that the shell is still there intact in some places where I painted it on. So my hope is that any place where you can still see white stripes where the paint was, I'm hoping that that is still solid shell so that when we pop it and we try and drain out the egg itself, that'll stay in place. Aha! So far, so good. This is hilarious. The egg, because the egg was starting to rot, it's expanded. So if you get a top-down view, you can actually see that the egg itself is expanding from where the shell was, which means this is gonna smell really great when I break it open. Gross. Gross, gross. It worked. There you go. Laser light show egg. We'll see if we can carve out that lining. See if we could just get that shell like we want. And yes, in case you're wondering, the entire studio smells like rotten egg and vinegar. A carved egg using nail polish and acid. Let's take a look at our polyurethane paint egg. Hopefully it'll pour out just as easy. I'm a little bit more concerned. If you take a look at this one, you'll notice that it doesn't look like the acetic acid has eaten through as much of the shell. Also, there seems to be some cracks up at the top on one side. I'm just very glad that Nate isn't in the studio today. He's not trying to eat anything right now. This one did not survive nearly as well as the nail polish did. You can actually see the cracks running through the shell. It still feels pretty stable. I still want to try though. It did eat through the sides. I don't know if it's going to work as well, but let's find out. Okay, well, so far so good. Similar results. You can definitely see that some of these sides did not hold up as well, but they're still there. I've already lost that one side right there. So I'm not even gonna finish trying. I am going to try and peel out that lining because the nail polish egg did survive me pulling out the lining. This one, just me trying to slice through, isn't working. If I pull it out, I have a feeling this whole thing's gonna crumple, but let's see. As I'm working, the whole egg is just crumbling. So I think that's as good as we're gonna get with regular, just clear acrylic paint. However, compared to our fully hollow egg, we're still doing better. So comparison time. We've got our fresh regular egg. We've got our control test plain egg, an egg with toothpaste, an egg with acrylic paint, a hollow acrylic paint egg, and then, shockingly to me, the nail polish egg. That's the one that survived. And now, obviously, I was just going for a very quick and easy design, something that I thought would structurally hold up, which it obviously did. But if you wanted to spend some time even with another sort of clear nail polish and really put in some detail, you can carve an egg without having to do much work. All you gotta do is paint it, put it in some vinegar overnight. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Click up there if you want to see our last video, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then.